This is KAG's HD Sports.
'Twas the night before SEC football begins, and Gamecocks and Aggies just couldn't wait. Another 6 hours for midnight yell and then kickoff on August 28. The barbecues and coolers were packed with brisket and beer, but there's no Clowney, Manziel, or Evans. Oh dear. South Carolina replaces an undefeated starting QB. The Aggs still expect a challenge, so let's hear from their leader on D.
I hear South Columbia is a crazy environment on game day, so I'm looking forward to that. You know, just their fans. I have a lot of friends that go to South Carolina, so hopefully I'll get to see them. But, you know, they're talking a lot of trash, my friends, but they think they're going to have a really good team this year, so hopefully we can go down there and kind of put that to sleep.
Put the rest of the rhyming on hold. Ironically, A&M and South Carolina's starting quarterback from last season, he now plays for the Cleveland Browns, Johnny Manziel and Connor Shaw. So Dylan Thompson and Kenny Hill get the start. It's the first matchup between the two teams on the football field. The 21st ranked Aggies and the 9th ranked Gamecocks start tomorrow night at 5:00 Central Time on the SEC Network. Sure, it's Wednesday, but we're about 48 hours away from the beginning of Friday Night Lights high school football across the state. The College Station Cougars won't participate this week, though. That's because they open the season tomorrow. Steve Huff and the Cougars travel to Rosenberg Terry after a 6-3 season. This is College Station High's first football game with any seniors on the roster in school history. Coach Huff feels there are things the Cougars must clean up between now and Thursday night.
One thing we found out last week, the kids played hard. You know, they ran around and we felt like we played fast. We made a lot of mistakes, but at the same time, I think that's one thing we're really working to correct this week. Kind of go back, look at the things that we're not doing so well, correct those, and that's not coach talk. It's just, you know, it's kind of what we need to do is clean up right now and get that taken care of, because it is a short week for us. So we definitely have to clean some things up.
CSHS could have the best fans in Texas, but no one will know if they don't participate in our contest. KAGS wants to see who is the best fan in Texas. College Station gets a head start on most, but don't be discouraged. You can send in your pictures and videos of who you think deserves to be the number one Texas high school football fan. We will partner with our other stations from around the state and shine the spotlight on the most diehard fans. You can submit them to us using the hashtag 1TXFan. The world really revolves around the hashtag now, it seems. Twitter really rules all.
And I have a feeling tomorrow a lot of people are going to leave work early to get ready for that Aggie football game at 5:00.
They may not even go into work, but not promoting that.
That might be Friday.
Can I do that?
We'll all take a break.
Yeah. All right, we'll have your last check of the forecast when we come back.